Hey, what's up guys, it's Ivan, and in this video I want to show you how to set up Google Ads conversion tracking in 2024 with the new updated and current interface so that it's easier for you guys to follow along with. Conversion tracking is absolutely essential before you get your campaigns running, guys, because you cannot hit a target that you can't see, right? You have no idea where you are unless you set this up and you see where you're going. So in the previous video, we set up this Ivan Mena free guide campaign. If you want to learn how to create a Google Ads campaign in 2024, check that video out. In this video, what we're going to do is we are going to set up conversion tracking for this little landing page I have here, this Learn Spanish Synergy Spanish product. And this is the thank you page, all right? So somebody enters their email, and then they'll be taken to the thank you page. And so let's suppose for the purpose of this video, we want to track how many people signed up to this page via Google Ads, right? So I am using Unbounce for these pages, by the way, okay? This is my favorite landing page builder of all time. I have many videos on it and many amazing things to say, but you don't have to use Unbounce. The idea is the same for what I'm going to show you, whether you're using WordPress, lead pages, you know, optimized press, whatever you're using, doesn't matter. Just follow along with me for the idea of what I'm showing you, okay? But I'll be using Unbounce in this example. So once you're in your Google Ads dashboard here, what you're gonna do is click on goals and click on summary. And we're gonna create a new conversion goal here together. So you're just gonna follow the steps here, click on new conversion action. We're gonna select website because we wanna track actions on our website. It doesn't only have to be signups, by the way. This could be sales, upsells, downsells, anything like that, all right? This, what I'm about to show you here will be applicable to anything. So it's saying scanning your website to determine if it's already set up. So I'm just gonna go ahead and copy this website here and scan it. I doubt anything will show up because we don't have any tracking set up. So we're gonna set this option here. This is the exact site, and Google's saying there's nothing set up, which is great because that's exactly what we're gonna do here now. So we're gonna select add a conversion action manually, and I'm gonna guide you through the steps. So the first option here is to select a goal, all right? So this is gonna be a submit lead form. This could also be a contact, right? So you can name it whatever you want. This is for your reference. This could also be a sign up. I'm gonna say submit lead form. And then we're gonna enter a name. So we're gonna say Synergy Spanish, let's say lead, okay? And then this is gonna give me an idea for once I have many conversions later on. Maybe I have an upsell, I have sales, I have many different products. This will tell me exactly what this conversion corresponds to. Now, you could also set a value. In this case, it's just a lead. We don't know how much exactly they're worth, but if you know your numbers for after somebody signs up, if they buy, you're able to work backwards and then figure out how much each lead is worth approximately. So if you have those numbers, you can go ahead and add them here. The same value for each conversion, or maybe different values for different conversions. For the purpose of this example, we're gonna say don't use a value because we don't know how much each lead is in this example. We don't have any sales yet. What you could also do is for every click, if somebody, for example, comes on and they sign up, maybe you have many different signup times, right, on your site. Maybe they can sign up here, then here, then here, many different options. Would you like that to count as one conversion for that one user? Or would you like that user to be considered as having three conversions for the three times that they, for example, sign up? This is totally up to you. I'm gonna go with one here so that if one person signs up several times, that will only count as one conversion for me. And then over here, you have all these different options for the click-through conversion windows, right? So the click-through conversion window is after somebody clicks on your ad, how much time do you want to give them before their conversion, before when they actually sign up, could be referenced back to your click, right? So let me give you an example. I think it'll be easier. So if we set it at 30 days, if somebody clicks on your ad and then 50 days later they convert, this will not be considered a conversion because this is past your window, right? However, if somebody clicks on your ad right now and they convert within 20 days, that will be considered a conversion. Even though they didn't convert immediately, right? What you're saying is, hey, because somebody clicked on your ad and they were influenced by your ad and by your page 20 days ago, we can consider this a conversion. So there's no right answer as to what you should set. The general rule of thumb is for bigger products, you should set the value as higher. For buying a house, buying a car, right? People don't just all of a sudden wake up and decide, okay, I'm gonna buy a house. and then they just buy a house the next day. They usually take a long time to do their shopping. So for things like that, you'd want to set your click-through window as higher, because people might look at your ad now and then buy something only 3 months later. And that's fine because it's a big purchase, so that would make sense. But for something like a pencil, right? Nobody's going to click your ad and then decide to come back and buy a pencil in 3 months. You know, they'll probably just get a pencil somewhere, or they'll just buy it right away because it's so cheap. So for smaller products, for smaller value products, I suggest setting a time window lesser, right? Lesser amount. 30 days is average. It's a normal amount you can set, you know, as a rule of thumb for anything, but that's what it is. That's the definition. Now, the next option here is engaged view conversion window. This is for videos, so it doesn't really apply if you don't have a video ad, if you just have a regular search ad, but this is basically the same exact thing. Is how much do you want to give people? Right here, it says conversion. How much do you want to give them to convert before that action is no longer deemed a conversion? So this is the same for you. In general, videos are more engaging, right? They engage people more, they get more of their attention. So that's why here the window, the default window, is a little bit less, just because of that. But that's basically what this is. Then you have the view through conversion window. This is after a person views your ad, do you want to count it as a view through conversion? So this isn't click through, they're not clicking, they're just seeing your ad, right? So this is gonna be the difference between somebody just seeing your ad, not even clicking on it, and then making the conversion. So again, how much do you want to give them, right? So a person may see your ad and not interact with it and then convert later. So this is called a view through conversion. So if you don't understand anything, you can read it over here by clicking on learn more. Google tells you the information. This attribution method, this is what I wanted to talk to you about. So these are actually no longer available, so I'm not gonna spend time explaining them. What they were basically is how you want to attribute your conversions. So first click means that if you have many different ads, right? If somebody clicks your first ad and then makes the sale, even though they click on many different ads in the process, only that first ad is gonna get the conversion. So that's basically what this attribution method is do you wanna attribute all your ads, in this case linear, to have part of the conversion, time decay, where the last ad will have the most conversions, first click, where the first ad will have the only one conversion, things like that. In this case, we only have last click and data driven. So last click means if you have many different ads, only the last ad, if somebody buys after looking at your last ad, only that last ad will get the conversion. So you have this option, or you have data driven, which is recommended. This is the best, the ideal solution. If you have many different conversions that Google can look at and analyze, then data-driven will correctly, or at least as accurately as possible, attribute the right amount of, the right percentage of a conversion to each dedicated ad that you have. This would be the most accurate, because this will say, okay, which of my ads had the most impact on my customers buying? Whereas if you select last click, it's just the last ad will have the only conversion, right? So ideally you wanna select this option. However, just keep in mind that you do need to have some conversions to for this to be accurate, right? I think before it was like you needed 60 conversions a month or something like that to be able to use this. I don't remember a number, but it was a lot. It was a meaningful number of conversions to be able to use it. Now you can use it as a default, but that's what this is. And then you have enhanced conversions, where basically whatever you have on your website, if there's some information about customers that Google already knows about, they can use that to help you get more conversions. So as they say here, it is a privacy safe way, so it doesn't violate anybody's privacy, but you can decide how you want to do this. In order to activate it, you do need to set up enhanced conversions. Because we don't have any campaigns with conversion tracking set up yet, we can't select it, but that's what that is. Then we're gonna click on done. And so here we have this conversion set up. So we're gonna click on save and continue. Now we have to actually add the code, right? So we're not just totally done. So if you have a Google Tag Manager, you can set that up using this. You can email instructions. Sorry, this is the Google Tag Manager, where if you have the Google Tag Manager, you just need to enter this into your Tag Manager and it's gonna work. You have the email instructions to your webmaster, and then you have the Google Tag, which is what we're gonna do. So the first thing we have to do is set this tag up on every single page of our website, right? So we're gonna put it on our landing page and on our thank you page, both. So we're gonna come back here, we're gonna click on setup, and then Google is gonna give us a big nasty code that we're gonna use. We're just gonna copy it, and I'm gonna show you where to put it. So it says here, below is the code, copy and paste it on every page of your website immediately after the head section of the tag. So we're gonna come in here, we're gonna click on this little copy button, and we don't have the test installation yet. So this is our landing page. Let's click on edit. I have different variations here. We'll just click on this variation. And then we need to edit this thank you page as well. So I'm just gonna click edit on both. And then here we're gonna go on JavaScript. We're gonna click on add new JavaScript, right? And I have different codes there, don't worry about those. But over here, we're gonna click on, we're gonna type in Google Ads tracking code. I believe I already have one. I'll just delete that one. So again, Google Ads tracking code. And then it says here, if you read the instructions, look, it says immediately after the head element, right? So if we come back here, it would be right here in the head. And what that does is that allows the code to fire instantly, to fire as soon as possible, right? Because the page loads from top to bottom. And so if you have this code in the head, then it's gonna load as fast as possible as well, as soon as the page loads. And then what we're gonna do is we're just gonna paste the code here. We're gonna click on done. We're gonna hit save. And we're gonna hit republish. And then we have to do the same thing on our thank you page as well. So we're gonna come back here. We're gonna say add new code. Let's delete those. We're gonna say Google Ads tracking code. We're gonna set it in the head. And then we're gonna put it here. We're gonna hit save. We can hit republish. Now that said, it's not a crime if you put the code in the body section, you know, that's okay. It's just the code will fire a little bit later, but that's fine. It's not a big deal. So this is good. The code should now be here on these pages, but let's come back into Google Ads and let's check. Let's click on test installation and it's gonna check to see if we have it. And it says the Google tag was detected correctly, okay? So we're gonna click on confirm. So this part is good to go. Now we need to measure the individual snippet. So what we've done is we've set up the main code on our site just to be able to communicate with Google. But what we didn't do is we didn't yet specify a specific action. Do we want to track sales? Do we want to track leads? Do we want to track upsells, downsells, calls? What do you want to track? In this case, we want to track leads, people who sign up. So we're going to click on see event snippet. And we need to add this snippet, right, on page load, when the page loads, to our thank you page. Because the only way somebody can sign up, the only way we know somebody has signed up is if they land on our thank you page after entering their email on the landing page. So we're gonna copy this, we're gonna go to our thank you page, we're gonna click on JavaScript. Now you can enter a new JavaScript and you can also enter it in the head, or you can just go to this existing one that you have and just hit enter and add another event snippet here. You can do it either way, okay? But it's probably easier for you to track each individual one if you just go to JavaScript and then type in Google Ads event code. This is the specific event. And then we can put it in the head as well. We can click enter and hit done. Now we can hit save, hit republish. And that is pretty much it. So now we will be tracking leads, right? So now we're done, okay? We're good to go. So if somebody lands on our landing page, signs up, and ends up on our thank you page, we're gonna see the conversion here in Google Ads. So we can go in here and hit done, and we should be good here. Now, you can check that you set this up via the Google Ads checker that you just saw, where it said conversion tracking set up correctly. And so that is pretty much it. Now you should be good to go. As long as you got that message that the code was detected on your site, you should be good. Now it's just a matter of actually running traffic to your campaigns and just making sure that the conversions show up. So if we go into our campaigns, let me quickly show you where you would see that. Under columns here, you should see it under conversions right there, okay? If you don't see that, you can click on columns, click on modify columns, go to conversions, and then add your conversions here, and then you should start seeing it here. If you know that you got conversions, but they don't show up in Google Ads, then that means something is off in the tracking. Rewatch the video, see what you did wrong. Alternatively, you can contact Google Ads support. They have a dedicated conversion tracking team that gets on the phone with you and guides you step by step in setting up conversion tracking. So you can do it that way, all right? And that is all for this video. If you guys enjoyed this content, I do invite you to check out my website at ivanmana.com, where I give you guys a free 55-page affiliate marketing guide to get you into affiliate marketing, as well as offer training courses, such as here, the Google Ads Mastery and Google Ads Retargeting courses, which are always updated and guide you through step-by-step in very thorough detail how to create profitable Google Ad campaigns. That is all for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next one.